Hi guys, this is Jamie from System 22 and Great Web Design, and welcome to this video. In this video, I want to add a Facebook feed to my Bootstrap website here. It's pretty easy to do, and it's a nice feature to have on your Bootstrap website. So the first thing we need to do, or the easiest way to do it I'm going to show you here, is go to developers.facebook.com, and I'll put this link down below. Once you're in there, you'll see this page, and you need to put the URL of the Facebook page that you'd like to embed in this little box right here. And I'll show you how to put your URL. It's pretty obvious, but for those of you that don't know, here we are. Here's the URL of the Facebook page that I want to embed there. So I just click on that and copy it and go back to that site. We don't actually need what's on the end of that URL there, but once you put it in there and refresh the page, it'll shorten it to the correct one. So I'll put that in there and we'll just refresh the page. And as you can see, it's shortened it to the correct version there. And if you just scroll down a little bit, here's a demo of what we're going to see, or an example of what the actual embedded code's going to look like once we've got this embedded in our site. And this is just what I'm looking for. It's a nice feature to have. Now all we need to do is get the code. So there's a nice little blue button. If we click on that, it will pop up a box here. Now for this tutorial, I'm going to use the iframe because it's very easy. And I'll just expand that a little bit. You can see what's going on. There's not a whole lot of code here. And all we need to do is find somewhere to put this in our site. So if we go back to our website that we want to put it in and scroll down, and let's find a place to put it. I'm not going to put it up here with the slider. I don't think I'll put it here in the intro section. But right here looks like a good place to put it. It would fit quite well there. I don't have to edit much of this. In fact, I don't have to touch that. I think I can put it there with no problem at all. Okay, so how are we going to do that, you say? Well, all you have to do is go to your index.html file, or whatever page.html file you want to embed it in. Open it in a text editor. I'm using Brackets, which is a great free one from brackets.io. I'll also put that link below. And once you've opened your page, you're going to get your HTML code here. So what we need to do is scroll down to that section where I want to put it. Let's just have a look. It's right there by the We're Ready. It's just under the welcome section right there. So if we go down, and let's try and find it. Here we are, there's the We're Ready. Here's the welcome section. And that is the image for that little iPad or whatever it is, the tablet looking, iPhone-y looking thing there. That's what we're actually going to replace. So we can go ahead and delete that. And get our code, which we had before from the developers.facebook.com here. Just select it, make sure it's all blue like that, and just roll your cursor up over it for those of you who don't know. Hit Control C to copy. Go back to our brackets text editor and just paste it in where we removed that photo there. Okay, now if we do a quick save, Control S, and go back to our index.html and do a refresh, now that little Facebook feed hopefully will be in that section there. Yep, there it is. And it's nice, you can scroll it, you can click on any of these posts here. You can like the page. So that is a very, very simple way of embedding a Facebook feed into your Bootstrap or HTML5 site. I'm going to take this a little bit further. I want to make that look a little bit more like how it looked before. If you remember, we had that sort of iPhone or iPad-y looking element there. So let's just add a little bit of code, bit of custom styling to this, see if we can't make it look a little better there. I mean, that's fine, but I want to take it a step further. So let's go back to our brackets here and have a look at the code. Okay, I've got width. That's how wide, obviously, how high. This is the styles here. Obviously, you can add, if you wanted to, you could add styles to your CSS files, but I'm going to go ahead and do it in line here. Scrolling, transition. That's fine. So we need to add some style here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to start by giving it a border of, let's say, 20 pixels solid, and a color of black, which is 000. And let's just have a look at that. Oh, before I do that, let's give it a border radius to make it look a bit more like an iPhone. That will give it rounded corners. So let's say 25 pixels. Okay, let's save that. Control S and take a look back at our site now. Let's do a quick refresh. There we go. It's given it that border, which is nice. It's getting there. It's looking a bit more like it. But I think the iPhone or what that thing before had a sort of larger border on the top and the bottom than it did from side to side. So let's adjust that. So go back to our brackets. And let's make this border left 20 pixels, and let's just copy that. I'll paste it next to it. Control V and make that border right. And let's just paste it one more time and make it border top. And now the border top, we want it almost twice as much. Let's try 40 pixels. Change that to 40 and paste it one more time. Border bottom, so this is bottom border, and again, we want a thick one. 40, like that, 40. So that looks good. Okay, let's do a Control S to save back to our site and a refresh. That's getting there. As you can see, the border at the top and the bottom are thicker than the side one, which makes it look a little bit more like one of those tablets or smartphones, which is the kind of effect I was looking for here. Now it looks like the inside part there is not really showing. It's almost cutting off on the right-hand side. So let's adjust that. So if we go back to our brackets, let's adjust on the width here. Let's try adding 20 pixels or so. So that'll be width of 360 now, which is not too wide for most smartphones. Should be able to handle that with no problem if people are browsing to your site on a smartphone, which a lot of people do. So Control S to save and back to the site. Let's do a refresh. Yeah, that looks a lot better. Yes, that looks a lot better. Now we can see the side of this, and we haven't got anything cut off there. And that scrolls nicely. So we're actually getting there, which is good. Yeah, everything's working. You can like the page, you can go to the page, you can scroll, and you can actually, let's make sure we can click on these blog posts to actually go to the pages. Yep, that's no problem. That works fine. Okay, well, that's pretty much there. Let's just put a cherry on the cake here, and let's give it a bit of a drop shadow underneath. just to give it a bit of depth. And to do that, let's go back to our brackets and add a drop shadow, or a box shadow. It is actually border right there, border radius. Let's put it right there, we'll do. And so that's box shadow. Let's make it, we don't want any left and right, we really want it on the bottom. So the first number is left and right, so I'm going to set that to 0. And the second number is top and bottom, or the bottom distance there. So let's give it 10 pixels to do it, probably. And you add a third attribute, which is the spread of the actual shadow, you know, whether it's a hard shadow or a soft shadow. So let's say that's about 15 pixels is what I usually use for this sort of thing. And now, of course, you've got to give it a color. So I wouldn't give it black, which is 000, but you want to get it pretty close to black. So let's give it something like 999 or 888. Let's try 888. Semicolon. Quick save, Control S, back to our site, and a refresh. Yeah, there you see we've got our box shadow effect underneath, which just gives it a little bit of a 3D look without being too heavy on the CSS there. And I think that's where we'll leave it. That's kind of the effect that I wanted. Like I say, it's a great idea to have a Facebook feed in your website. People can just go to your site, read your post there on the site, click on them to get to them, like your page. So there we have it. I hope that's been useful to you. Once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and greatwebdesign.com. Thanks for watching and have a great day. Bye-bye.